Hi friends, this is day 11 of our lockdown. So yesterday we have seen some ocular side effects of drugs which are affecting the cornea, keratopathy, then uveitis, then glaucoma, then cataracts, I told you, and then in important, I told you some points regarding retina, drugs affecting retina. One of them was the question of yesterday, that was chloroquine. Today we'll see some drugs which are affecting the optic nerve, as I told yesterday. The question was, the patient was on ATT in complaints of blurring of vision and impairment of color vision. Which is the least likely cause? So I don't know, many people, I think it was a very easy question, but many people, I think they missed least likely, or I mean, I don't know why they have answered A. A is the most likely drug. Ethambutol is the most likely drug. The least likely is rifampicin out of the ATT drugs. Okay. So that was a very simple question. You should remember that many ATT cause optic neuropathies except rifampicin. That was the answer. So let us see some drugs and some related what points you should remember for your PG exam level. So toxic optic neuropathies mostly affects, see this I told you, is retina fibers, and they mostly affect these papillomacular bundle. Papillo means optic disc and joining the macula. So these fibers are mostly affected in the toxic optic neuropathies, and this papillomacular bundle, if it is involved, so the visual field effect, which you have to remember, macula is responsible for central vision. So there will be central scotomas or centrocecal scotomas. So because of involvement, there is a central scotoma and a centrocecal scotoma because of involvement of papillomacular bundle. See, this is right visual field. The black one is a blind spot in the temporal. That's why it is right. This central scotoma and centrocecal are particularly involved when there is an optic nerve disease, like optic neuropathies. One example, because of toxins. So ATTs, as I told you, ethambutol is the most likely drug, and majorly the drug dose which is given 15 milligram per kg single on a daily basis, that is very less dose to cause optic neuropathies. What important point is, it is reversible. On stopping of ethambutol, it reverses. Rifampicin is the least likely TB drug which can cause. That was a question answer for today. Okay, tobacco is another important drug which you remember, which can cause toxic optic neuropathies. What in tobacco? You have to remember two points. Cyanide in tobacco causes optic neuropathy, and of course you have to abstain tobacco, and if it is a severe disease, then you have to give intramuscular injection of hydrocobalamin 1000 milligrams. That is two points you have to remember for tobacco. That's why it is known as tobacco amblyopia. Now amblyopia should not be used. Previously it was used tobacco amblyopia. Amblyopia means there is loss of vision, unexplainable. But amblyopia is a misnomer here. So tobacco toxicity is used. Okay, first, then alcohol. See, tobacco, alcohols are sometimes intermingled use, but which alcohol? Obviously, when people smoke, they drink also, they drink alcohol. So ethyl alcohol and tobacco is tobacco, ethyl alcohol together. But what important point is, methyl alcohol is more dangerous than ethyl. And that's why you must have seen people, you must have read in newspapers that when the people, they take the country liquor, they see liquor, then they get blind. That is because of methyl alcohol acute poisoning, because the metabolic acidosis is there. Methyl alcohol acute poisoning can cause. This happened recently in this coronavirus lockdown in Iran. They thought that it's responsible for decreasing the virus load. That caused blindness in many, even death in many patients in Iran. So methyl alcohol poisoning can cause toxic optic neuropathies. Then some drugs, chloramphenicol, distral, chloroquine was yesterday's question. Chloroquine, yes, it causes keratopathy, then cataracts, then bullseye maculopathy, and consecutively it can cause optic neuropathy as well. Not direct effect, consecutively because of retina involvement. Amiodarone was another drug which I told you yesterday can cause keratopathy, vortex keratopathy. Okay, it can cause toxic optic neuropathy, and it resembles, the point you have to remember is, it resembles non-arteritic ischemic optic neuropathy. The resemblance of optic nerve is the same in both of them. So, you have to differentiate these two conditions. They both look like same, and it is not related to dose. That is also an important point. But of course, if do people have toxic optic neuropathies, then you have to stop the drug. Okay, then some toxins, lead, arsenic, quinine and vicabatrin. You have to remember, the last point for today, quinine and vicabatrin causes visual field effect. They constrict the visual field from periphery like this. This is what looking like a tunnel. This is tunnel, right? This is left. Patient standing like you. This is blind spot. Okay, so this is right, this is left, this is tunnel vision. They constrict the visual field, vicabatrin and quinine. Please remember these two points, two drugs causing tunnel vision, constriction of visual fields. Alright, so that is some points regarding optic neuropathies because of drugs. And these are some points for the ocular side effects of drugs. Okay, thank you.